Well, the world champion Rob Cross has put up a good performance there. It was a comfortable 6-1 victory in the end. An average of just shy of 106 and a 75% success rate on his doubles, which included double 14 to round up the match and run out a convincing winner. We can take a look at his stats now, and these numbers are impressive.
Yeah, it's more like Rob Cross. This is the version of Rob Cross that went on to win the Worlds in January. He's been playing well all season, but he'd have a game like this, and then in the next match he'd average sort of 90-odd and not get away with it. But winning that Players' Championships a couple of weeks ago, which was his first title of 2018, that's incredible for a world champion, has obviously given him a mental lift.
We heard in commentary, didn't we, since the world champion victory, 14 quarterfinals, semi-finals, or finals appearances without that victory until you mentioned that winning the Players' Championship. So he was getting close, but he wasn't getting over the line, Al.
Yeah, he just wasn't performing to the level that we saw towards the end of last season in the middle part. He was getting there and thereabouts and having the odd really, really good game, but just not getting over that line to the consistent level. And the more the season went on, the harder he was finding it at the later stages.
Yeah, he struggled. He struggled with the whole thing.
Just very quickly, our next game's about to come. Gowen Price is playing. He's got an Achilles injury on his non-standing leg. How much of a problem is that going to be?
Yeah, it shouldn't be too bad. I've sort of followed him since the injury happened, and he's been playing okay. He's been posting some good numbers.
He injured it running. It was a free.
Yeah,
injury,
it's a tear in his Achilles, but he's got to have an operation on it. But of course, he can't have an operation now because there's no way he was going to turn down the opportunity to play in the World Series and the World Match Play.
Alan, he's playing Dawson Michelli, we can see walking onto the stage. Now, he caused a massive upset last year, defeating James Wade. Will we see an upset here against Gerwin Price?
Well, he could do. You know, we know what he's like on the stage. He can raise his game. He's going to have to raise it again to a better level. Had a big weekend. Well, yesterday, obviously disappointed, but now, different game.
Yeah, looking forward to seeing
James Wade go out, so anything can happen.
Looking forward to seeing those moves from you a little bit later on this evening.
Not quite sure what that was.
Let's take you back to the hotel in Vegas, the Mandalay Bay, and rejoin MC John McDonald.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen from South Wales. Would you please welcome a UK Open finalist, ladies and gentlemen, the Iceman, Gerwin Price!
Well, back in the city where the PDC dream began for Dawson Mercial. Here in Vegas, he produced an incredible win over James Wade that was the platform that he used to establish his PDC career. Now he's moved over to the UK, he's mixing it with the big guns on a weekly basis. But back here in the States, the young Canadian from Medicine Hat. Didn't make it up. It's written there. Has got a chance to take out another big name. These two actually met in last year's US Darts Masters. Gerwin Price went on to make the semi-finals after beating Dawson 8-4 in the quarters. There he was absolutely battered by Michael van Gerwen. But we've got a match-up here between two guys. One of them who has danced his way onto stage. And Dawson does have form with some questionable dance moves on PDC stages over the last few weeks. Against a guy who's struggling to walk because Gerwin Price has done his Achilles playing football and he's got it very heavily strapped up. It is causing him problems, although he says it doesn't hurt him. But then again, these rugby boys, and he is a former rugby player, they're pretty tough lads.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, first leg is Gerwin to throw first. Game on.
If you snap your Achilles, it is going to be painful. Chucking Tungsten through the pain barrier, Gerwin Price. For the right to take on either Gary Anderson or the big American DJ Sayer, who are coming up next. I'll be interested to see how Dawson Mercial reacts after his dramatic defeat in the semi-final of the North American Championship yesterday here at the Mandalay Bay, where he was beaten by John Norman Jr. Threw it away, really. Should have been in the final. Ifs, buts, could, shoulds, and maybes. But he was not a happy chappy as he raced off the stage.
And
that one's improved his mood. 180 for Price. Mercial is having an absolute mare of a first leg here. Double 10 it is.
80.
That would have won a leg by almost 400 points. Scores of 22, 27 and 60 for Dawson at the moment. Anything
60.
But.
60. Go 20. Yeah, Sean, the first leg.
They got there
going
in the
price. Saying it's Dawson to throw first.
Comfortable hold of throw for the world number 12.
125.
Defeat yesterday was tough for young Dawson to swallow, but he's dusted himself down. Today's another day.
100.
As we mentioned, the star of the show on the opening day of the US Darts Masters 12 months ago, Dawson Mercial, beating James Wade. If you're just joining us, Wade just got out of jail again earlier on today. Came from 5-3 down to beat the young American Danny Lawby. Survived match darts, but history didn't repeat itself. And Wade is still in the mix. Quarterfinals are shaping up. Rob Cross will play Michael Smith. Wade will play the winner of Van Gerwen and Jeff Smith.
42.
The winner of this plays Anderson or Sayer. And it's Wright or Huffman against Gurney or Norman Jr. That's all the action on
140.
Saturday here in Vegas.
Well, Mercial has got a victory over Gerwen Price
98.
In the past, not very recent past as well. Played each other in May in a Pro Tour event. Went all the way to a last leg decider, which Dawson.
Dawson Irigoyen, 96. Yeah, it's
on the second leg.
Very nicely done. Let's go to the first game.
It must hurt. As you say, heavily strapped. We'll have to kill his of Gerwen Price, but.
100!
It was a poor first leg for the young Canadian. He's been pretty tidy since, though.
Yeah, Gerwen, when he was describing what happened to him.
140!
He's playing football and he'd gone in goal, and then he went back outfield again. He seized up because he wasn't doing much in goal. So then when he started running, he said, I genuinely thought somebody was throwing a brick at me. It felt that bad. But he has been playing. He's been playing some pretty decent stuff we've seen over the last couple of weeks going Price, despite this injury. So it's not, it can actually, ironically, get
65.
You to focus a bit more, because you're not moving any parts, any other parts of your body. You're trying to keep still, so all that's moving is the arm. And it can actually improve your throw in a weird kind of way.
60. Dawson Irigoyen, 160.
Well, six darts here for young Dawson to take this leg against the throw. He may need them.
40. Ninety-six. Dawson Uruguay, 120.
To hit the front.
Gets the treble. Now needs a single. Now needs the double. Moving right, moving left, trying to find a way through.
100. Dawson Uruguay, 100.
A little treble. May look at tops, tops here. So a real chance for Dawson Mercer.
78. Dawson Uruguay, 20.
To break throw.
It's on the third leg, Dawson Mercer.
And break
for me, it's Dawson to throw first.
So I'm at the World Cup of Darts, of course. Awesome Dawson playing with John Parts. That was, again, another PDC stage with some questionable dance moves. Dragged out by Awesome Dawson. A blend of youth and experience in that team. The great man John Parts, the three-time world champion, did try qualifying for this, didn't make it through. But five of the eight North American qualifiers seen in action today, all from Parts country of Canada.
134.
The switch from Young Dawson. Because the prize was so huge for the winner of the North American Championship yesterday, double the disappointment for Mercer, who was denied the opportunity to play his great friend and mentor Jeff Smith in the final. Smith was the man with his eyes on the prize. Here, Gerwin has his
96.
Eyes on the ball.
Dawson Uruguay, 82.
And so will Mercer here, ball for double 16. Tops it is.
62. Dawson Uruguay, 25.
Double 12. We'll break straight back and level the game. And a shake there for Gerwin Gray, so he's only one out of six on his doubles. It's a gift for the young Canadian, this.
Pinch on the fourth leg, Dawson Mercer. The leg is going to throw first.
Good reaction. Oh dear, Gerwin.
Genuinely would have been better to have thrown that last dart off the stage and in the bin.
Yeah. Well, we remember that.
58.
The most famous bounce out of all, I think, at the World Championship 4 years ago. Gary Anderson beat Phil Taylor. The start of the fourth set, the first leg. Gary Anderson saw 180 bounce out onto the floor. Two darts in, the last dart went in the treble.
84.
Took the other two out and then fell out itself.
Yeah, the running score in that visit, 60, 120, nothing.
Yeah.
100.
But he still won the set.
And of course the title, and we get to see Anderson on after this one against DJ Sayer. DJ Sayer, of course, the man who took on Dawson Mercer in the first round yesterday, and probably the highest quality game that we saw in the North American Championship. Fantastic stuff from the pair of them.
60.
And we saw earlier on when James Wade was taking on Danny Lawby. Lawby had his chances 41. To bury him. And he did not take them. And that's probably partially down to inexperience and realising what enormous achievement he was about to grab a hold of. Well, Dawson, he's already been there. He's already done it. He's won on a Vegas stage before in a World Series event. And playing week in, week out against the biggest names in the world, that should have removed a bit of the fear
100.
Factor.
100, Gonyugwa, 44.
Needed it's that.
On the fifth leg, going prize. Single leg, it's Dawson, the throw first.
The Canadian who has that breaker throw.
Well, look, there's 10 points difference in the averages here. But, as Dawson Mitchell has just shown, ever since the end of that first leg, he's been right there with Gerwyn Price. It's just that first leg was so, so awful that it's going to drag down his average for the entirety of his game. So forget about the numbers. The only numbers you need to worry about, a little column saying legs next to these guys' name.
46.
Good recovery from the Welshman.
Ninety-five. Number 40.
Gets him within striking distance of a 4-2 lead. But Gerwyn Price is going to be there as well. Fantastic setup shot.
Wilson Uruguay, 86.
Oh, a fabulous setup shot. Michel started with 177. Nearly double 16 here. Huge dart.
In 76
it goes. The 162.
First.
It's
game.
All in vain!
59.
Well, the sixth World Series event for Gerwyn Price. Two semi-finals in Dubai and, of course, here in Las Vegas last year. But in real danger in the first round of the US Darts Masters here at the Mandalay Bay. A second maximum for Dawson Mitchell. Is it going to be
58?
Another big day in the career of this young Canadian.
And I think we're seeing again here that the pressure is kind of off the Americans and Canadians playing here against the big names, because they are the underdogs. Yesterday, Dawson was among the favourites to go and book his place at Ali Pali, and it might have told on him. I mean, he's running around here like a whippet having eaten a big bag of E-numbers. He is a little bundle of energy and enjoying every single second. And why not? Because he is taking the world number 12 to a very, very precarious place.
43. Dawson Uruguay, 138.
Another sarcastic self-applause from the Welshman. Tells you all you need to know.
180.
Well, brilliant. To lead 20 out of 12 darts.
60. Dawson Uruguay, 20.
Well, a couple of visits to see this off. And for a break of throw, and Dawson Mitchell is going to be the heavy, heavy favourite if he takes this out.
16.
But he will come back and have another go.
50. Dawson Uruguay, 4.
The three darts already missed. Three more in his hand.
Games on the side. Dawson the third. He's next Dawson to throw first.
Another big, big win. And another big, big upset here in Las Vegas.
Game on.
Dawson Mercial convinced himself that he had a future in PDC darts off the back of his victory against James Wade in this tournament last year. It was Gerwin 96. Price in the next round that ended his dreams of having a deep run. A bit of revenge
for Dawson Mercial
is on the cards, because it looks like the world number 12 and the Welsh number 1 will be leaving Las Vegas very soon.
100.
He'll keep on scrapping Gerwin Price for sure.
Ninety-one. 58.
With the lip getting more pronounced, which suggests to me that he really is struggling.
96.
Gerwin on the stage.
7-score.
I think that just sums up his
118.
Yeah, really struggling. Dawson Mercial now with 6 darts to cause another big shock. Well, double-double!
86.
Well, that would have been incredible. That's exactly what he meant to do as well, make no mistake. How about that for a bit of panache? Can he finish 40. It off? Can he win
Wasn't
here?
32.
Bit of showboating in Vegas from awesome Dawson Mercial.
And you require 131.
Well, that's just pressure, pure and simple. So he's had 4 match darts.
77.
Dawson Mercial.
Doesn't he require 8?
How many more will he need?
8. For the second year running, Dawson Dawson takes out a big name in the US Darts Masters, and he is into the quarterfinals. Gerwin Price, not enough to stop the 22-year-old who loves every single minute of being on that stage. And you'll get to see him again in this tournament. He'll be back tomorrow to face either DJ Sayer or Gary Anderson, the 2-time world champion.